So I just finished Moon Knight on Disney Plus, and I thought it was okay. Honestly, guys, I think I'm starting to get a bit sick of the MCU. I feel like Marvel has been churning stuff out nonstop since the start of Phase 4 with WandaVision, and it's all just getting to be a bit much nowadays. I miss the days when they did only like one or two projects a year. That was more than enough of the MCU for me. Now, I feel like we get something new from Marvel every week. In the span of only 6 months, from December 17th, 2021 to June 17th, 2022, we will have gotten content from 5 different Marvel projects. That is fucking insane. And between the movies and the TV shows, by the end of the year, we will have gotten 10 different Marvel projects from December 2021 to December 2022. And that's just too much. I'm sorry. The thing is, I wouldn't even be that upset about it if Marvel didn't have the problem that it's had for the past almost 15 years. And that's the fact that everything from Marvel feels the same. I feel like I've talked about this issue a million times in past videos I've done on the MCU, but basically, Marvel has the same cringy writing, awkward jokes, juvenile humor, formulaic story structure in just about every single thing they produce. At least with DC, they make movies that, no matter how bad some of them are, feel different from one another. Batman v Superman feels nothing like Wonder Woman, which feels nothing like Aquaman, which feels nothing like Shazam, which feels nothing like Birds of Prey. The DCEU really lets its directors add their own unique flavor to each movie, which is why you can really tell each movie was made by a different person. With the MCU, if you told me that every single movie was directed by the same guy, I wouldn't even be remotely surprised. They all just feel the same, so unless you have some personal investment in a particular character or something, chances are you're not really going to care when something new comes out. At least that's what happened with me. I did not really feel like watching Moon Knight. Not because I hated the character or the story or anything, but because I just got kind of tired of the same old from the MCU. And as of me writing this script, I have yet to see Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness, and I have no sense of urgency to go see it. I don't care. I just don't care anymore. You've given me too much of the same thing for too long. And it's probably making it worse that you're giving me all this stuff at a higher frequency than before. It's like that thing where you have a friend that has some problems you can overlook, but then you decide to start rooming with them, and now because you're dealing with those problems all the time, that friend is just becoming unbearable. And that's what the MCU is like. The MCU is that friend that I'm perfectly fine with in small doses, but when they start hanging around me all the time, I just can't deal with them anymore. I haven't even started talking about Moon Knight yet, Jesus. Well, to start, even if I wasn't super excited for this series, I will say that there were a few things that I liked. One of my favorite things about this show was the fact that this definitely played out more horror-like. And I liked the way they did it by playing with Stephen Grant's broken mental state to create these horrifying and creepy scenarios. His mental state also makes it so that we as the audience are often just as confused as to what's happening as he is. Which is pretty neat when you can make the audience feel what the protagonist is feeling. This show is constantly making you question what is actually real and what isn't. And all the while, Stephen Grant / Mark Spector is trying to figure this out too. And similarly to this show having more horror than what is typically in the MCU, this show is also way darker and more violent than a lot of the other stuff in the MCU. However, the main problem with this series is that, at least for the first half of season 1 with the first 3 episodes, I was really bored. The main conflict on its own was not really that engaging, with Mark / Steven trying to stop Harrow from unleashing Amit, but the first 3 episodes were really boring because they just set up all the main characters, what their motivations are, what relationships they share with one another, and it's all a lot of setup, and none of the real development or meat of the story really happens until the second half of the season. I get that since this is an origin story for Moon Knight, you do need to do these things, but I don't know, it just wasn't very exciting to me. However, once they reach Amit's tomb at the beginning of episode 4, that's when things really start picking up. Before that, a lot of it was just traveling from place to place, and any interaction with the main villain, Arthur Harrow, really just didn't feel all that tense or threatening. He kind of just walks around and explains to everyone what his plan is, and he really doesn't do anything that makes them feel like a threat. I mean, yeah, he does murder people by judging them with his tattoo, but I don't know. I just never really felt scared by him. He felt more intimidating in the second half. Like, that's when he actually does shit. Like, he straight up executes Mark Spector. Everything's better in the second half, if we're being completely honest, though. When we got to the Duat and we started getting more into the Egyptian mythology with the Ushabtis and avatars, that's when things got interesting. But admittedly, I might be a bit biased because as a Percy Jackson fan who also read any other book by Rick Riordan, including his books on Egyptian mythology, I came in with a lot of pre-existing knowledge on Egyptian mythology and was thoroughly entertained whenever this show got into that stuff. Once I saw Tawaretted at the end of episode 4, I knew exactly where we were and what was going to happen, because the old story went that the sun god Ra would travel through the Duat or the Egyptian underworld each night, battling the chaos serpent Apophis, and it was his journey through the underworld and rebirth at the crack of dawn each morning that was the reason for each sunrise. So I knew that Mark Spector slash Stephen Grant were going through the Duat and were going to be reborn, just like Ra. But also that whole personal journey towards rebirth, where we got to see what caused this split personality, was really dark, especially when we got to the scene where we saw Mark's mother abuse him. But seeing Mark and Steven learn to work in harmony and finally start to get along was really nice to see, and it all led up to the final battle where, along with Layla's help, who was avataring for I'm not gonna say it anymore, which was badass, Mark slash Steven really came into their own as the Moon Knight. However, once Mark slash Steven beat Harrow, I do have to say that the very, very end felt kind of rushed. Like, they beat Harrow, Mark slash Steven tells Khonshu to kill Harrow himself if that's what he wants, and then they just wake up in Steven's apartment and it's over. And honestly, when it ended, I was like, is that it? They didn't show what happened with Layla or where their relationship stood. They just ended it right after they beat the villain. Usually, stories will at least explain or close up some stuff, but with this show, it was like, alright, yep, that's it. We beat the villain, mission accomplished, show's over. It just felt really abrupt, and I would have liked the ending to feel a bit more definitive. I will say that I did like the post-credit scene where Jake Lockley, Mark's third personality, was finally revealed. It definitely leaves room for the character to be further explored. So overall, not a bad series. There were definitely some things that made it unique, but there were also a good amount of things that were either really boring or I didn't like. So I'm going to wrap it up and give Moon Knight a 6 out of 10.